So you've heard about Dulkar Salman's latest movie Kurup. The film has the Malayalam actor playing the character Sukumar Kurup, India's longest hunted fugitive. What is Sukumar Kurup's story? Why has he captured Kerala's attention for so many decades? We are here to give you everything you need to know about the original Sukumar Kurup. But before we do that, a quick reminder to become a member of the News Minute community, because stories take time, effort and resources. We cannot do this without your support. So click on the link in the description below to become a member of the News Minute community, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And now back to Kurup. This is a slightly long story, but one that's going to be very intriguing. It was the wee hours of January 22, 1984. A man called Suresh Kumar saw a car burning in a farm next to his house in Kunnam in Alappuzha. He found a body that was completely burnt inside the car. As Kunnam woke to the shocking news that day, many recognized the ambassador car with the number plate KLQ7831. It belonged to 36-year-old Sukumar Kurup, an NRI based out of Abu Dhabi, and Sukumar's house was in Chengannur, just 10 kilometers away. Many believed that it was Kurup who had been killed in the car accident. But one man, Deputy SP Haridas, did not believe this theory, and that started off an investigation. Sukumar Kurup's accomplices were all punished, but to this day, Kurup remains elusive. From Bhutan to Mumbai, the police were on the hunt for Kurup for many, many years, but they never found him. This is the story of Kerala's most elusive con man, a fascinating investigation, and a family that is still waiting for justice. After Suresh Kumar discovered the car and the dead body inside it, police officials from the nearby police station rushed there, as did DYSP Haridas and Dr. Uma Dattan, who was to carry out the post-mortem. Haridas and his team found a pair of slippers and a pair of rubber gloves near the car. A strand of hair was stuck to the gloves. A can of petrol was also found in the car, and there were footprints on the field as if somebody had walked away. People who had gathered around recognized Sukumar Kurup's car and assumed that he'd been killed in the accident. On the post-mortem form, however, Haridas wrote body believed to be Sukumar Kurup. Dr. Uma Dattan also grew suspicious about the accident theory as he started conducting the post-mortem of the charred body. The man had no wristwatch or slippers, and Uma Dattan wondered if an NRI would go out without any of these. At first glance, there appeared no signs that the person was burnt alive, and this was proved on the post-mortem table. There were no signs of soot in the lungs or trachea. If Kurup was alive when his car burst into flames, he would have inhaled the soot. When the abdomen was opened, there was a peculiar smell. It wasn't just alcohol that the person had consumed, but some other toxic substance too. Uma Dattan and Haridas understood two things: that the man may have been poisoned and that he was badly burnt after he died. So what was first an NRI's death in an accident quickly turned into a murder investigation. But who was murdered? Was it Sukumar Kurup? This was the next question. When the officers went back to the police station, Kurup's brother-in-law Bhaskaran Pillai was waiting for them. He claimed that Kurup had enemies in Abu Dhabi and they had killed him. One thing about Bhaskaran Pillai that struck Haridas was the fact that he was wearing full-sleeve shirt. Haridas asked him to roll up his sleeves and discovered burn marks on his arms. Uma Dattan immediately examined him and found more burn marks on his body, and Bhaskaran Pillai's hair was completely singed. When he was questioned, Bhaskaran Pillai made a startling claim that Kurup owed him 50,000 rupees and he had a brawl over it with him and killed Kurup in anger. The police now had a confession in hand, but Haridas was still skeptical. Uma Dattan recalls that this was because Haridas had sent cops in plain clothes to Sukumar Kurup's house. They discovered there that the family was not in mourning. In fact, they had cooked chicken curry that day, which is unusual if a death had occurred in the family. Haridas also got a tip-off that someone who looked like Sukumar Kurup was spotted in a lodge in Alua, but by the time the police team reached, he'd left. There was another puzzle too in this story. Kurup's most trusted aide and driver, Ponnappan, had gone missing with Kurup's second car. As the funeral for Kurup was being held, Ponnappan returned. he made a completely different confession to Kurup's uncle, which the police were informed of immediately. Ponnappan said that he and Kurup were driving in the car and hit a man by accident. When they discovered that the man was dead, they panicked and burnt his body in the car. Now the police had two versions, one by Bhaskaran Pillai and another by Ponnappan. Ponnappan's version made no sense and was immediately rejected. There were no accident-like injuries on the body, and it made no sense that they burned the body in the very same car. After days of interrogation, Bhaskaran Pillai finally confessed. Sukumar Kurup had taken an insurance policy of over 3 lakh dirhams. He needed more money to finish the construction of his lavish house. Sukumar Kurup, Bhaskaran Pillai, Ponnappan and another friend called Shahu decided to fake Kurup's death and claim the insurance money. They first decided to steal a dead body from the Alleppey Medical College with the help of Madhu, Sukumar Kurup's relative who worked there. But the post-mortem would show the body was preserved in formalin, and they decided against this. Their next idea was to steal a body from the crematorium, but the caretaker was not willing to take part in this plan and did not cooperate. On Jan 21st, the gang decided to simply find a man who resembled Kurup and stage his death. That very night, they drove 23 kilometers on the national highway, but they found no one. As they were returning home, they found their victim. A young man was standing outside the Hari movie theater in Karuvatta, and he asked them for a lift. They forced the young man to drink alcohol that was mixed with ether. Then Bhaskaran Pillai strangled him to death. After dousing the body with petrol, the gang drove with it to the nearby farm. They put the body in the car and set the car on fire. But while doing so, Bhaskaran Pillai and Ponnappan suffered burns and fled, discarding the gloves and the petrol can. So now the police knew that a man had been killed for insurance money. But who was this man? This was the next question. A police station reported that a man named Chaku, a film representative, had gone missing, and his wife confirmed that he had gone to the Hari movie theater that very day. Now the next step was to prove that the body was Chaku's. The body was exhumed on Feb 1st, and Dr. Umadatan did two things. First, he did a photographic superimposition of the head. An enlarged photo of Chaku was placed on the skull, and that was a match. Though the lower part of the jawbone was missing, the rest of the face was a complete and perfect match. Dr. Umadatan then recreated the right foot. To get it right, they worked on 13 dead bodies and used clay for flesh. When they tried Chaku's footwear on the reconstructed foot, finally it fit perfectly. The trial of the case started at the Alleppey Sessions Court in 1990, and the court found Bhaskaran Pillai and Ponnappan guilty of murder. Shahu had turned a prosecution witness in the case. The judgment copy shows that the prosecution was able to prove murder with many witnesses, like Sukumar Kurup's relative Madhu, who confessed that it was him who sourced the anesthetic ether for them. Burn marks on Bhaskaran Pillai and Ponnappan, hair found on the gloves belonged to Bhaskaran Pillai, Chaku's blood was found in Bhaskaran Pillai's house. All this helped the prosecution. But the testimony of one of the most important witnesses proved that Sukumar Kurup was alive on Jan 22nd. The man who worked at the Alankar tourist home in Alua, and he had checked in Kurup and remembered his face. But even as Bhaskaran Pillai and Ponnappan were given life imprisonment, Sukumar Kurup was on the run. For many years, Haridas and other police officers followed tip-offs from everywhere, but every single time, Kurup escaped. To this very day, Kurup features on the Interpol Red Alert list. A 73-year-old man with a black mole on the right side of his cheek and a black coloration over the right ear. And this man continues to be on the run.